Yo, 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 what's up, everyone? It's Barbarisi from the BX, now in Manhattan. What's going on, guys? How's everybody doing today? Whew, Lord. So I got the YouTube app going, and let me show you guys how much I have done. Okay, look at this. Okay, I've done this. Okay, I just fixed this all up. Dusted that. Look at this, guys. I did this. I did all of this. Yes, I'm listening to Mr. Reed's live. What's up, Mr. Reed? How you doing? How you doing, Tom? I don't know if you still watch my videos. How are you? Yeah, guys. Barbarisi, you know, I feel bad for that baby. Jessica's baby. I feel bad. I'm sorry. This is, you know, because I'm a child advocate and I understand. Isn't that nice? I've had that for about 8 years. I am a child advocate. Listen, I was pregnant in the streets too, and I got judged just for having a child in the streets. And I have footage. And what's your name again? I'm so sorry. Lord God, forgive me. One of my first subscribers. Oh, my God. From Australia. I'm going to look you up, baby. I still remember your first name, but I don't want to expose your first name. But, yeah, man. He showed me the footage. First of all, he's the one who linked me to Tom's videos. He said, you know what? Maybe Tom can help you. He's like, you know, since Chris Arnotti didn't help you, maybe Tom can help you. And when I first got on Tom's chat, I didn't want to ask for help because I didn't care about subs and nothing like that. And that's the God's honest truth, you know. And the truth is that just for having a baby on the streets, I was judged, shunned, and put through the ringer, even for having Weedy B, drug-free and everything. I never had custody of that baby. And why they put me through the ringer? Just for having a child out in the streets. Even though I never had custody of that baby. The baby was safe, in a safe place, in the hospital. Nothing, you know, nothing crazy, you know, God forbid. Come on, I could never ever do that to a baby. I have hard enough taken into consideration. Excuse me, I'm listening to some, I'm gonna sing this song later. Mama Deep End watches I dive in, I'm underneath the ground. Far from the surface, where they can hurt us, far from the shallows now. In the shallows, in the shallows, in the shallows. Shallows, we're far from the shallows now. Oh, I could sing, guys. I could sing. I really, really can. When I want to, Barbarisi can blow a few out. And that's the God's honest truth. All gifts from the Lord. Guys, so I'm going to tell you the rest of this. And then I'm gonna get back to what I was saying. Weedy B was with Mama all morning. I just started finishing this venture. I played with him, did everything I had to do, took care of my baby. Tito wasn't feeling good. You know, guys, he usually doesn't, and that's the truth. And someone made a comment about him being laid out on the floor. And saying that the baby, you know, what's up with that? I ain't gonna say nothing else. And I said to them, well, you know, I understand and I agree with you to an extent. I said, but Tito is sick. He doesn't have the energy that I have. Yeah, okay, my son shouldn't see him laying out on the floor, but some people like to sleep on the floor. You know, listen, Tito's doing the best that he can do for the health condition that he has. And yes, my health isn't so great right now, but me and Tito think differently. I'm a person of, and this is nothing of my own accord. I think on a higher level of thinking. I don't worry myself. Even when those people came into my life, I'm the cup half full person. I've always been that way, by the grace of the good Lord. So even though my day, I run myself ragged, listen, this is my son. So, you know, for me to be complaining about that would be so, I would feel so good, like, damn, like, come on, you complain about taking care of your kid, girl? What the fuck is wrong with you? I wouldn't be able to look in the mirror. No, I only tell the truth that, yeah, okay, I run myself ragged, but it's for my son, and that's the truth. Yeah, okay, I don't get time to even sit down or get time to relax, and while I'm making this video, because I like to tell my story about what's going on, in the meantime, I'm finishing up what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? Look, I'm fixing the bed right now, about to wipe the bed down because, you know, the baby jumps around the bed with crumbs and cookies and stuff, and I gotta clean it off and whatnot. So, you know, I'm doing the thing. I'm doing the thing. But I, as far as Jessica's concerned and the baby, you know, I don't, listen, I wasn't there. I know how hard it was for me on the streets of Hunts Point. Being pregnant, I've been attacked, I've been raped, I've been all that while I was pregnant. I've had 15 to 20 rags shoved up my vagina while I was pregnant, and I found out while I was locked up. I mean, this is the truth of the streets, you know, living on the streets like this while you're pregnant. It's hard. How everyone gets to that point, each paths are different. Everyone's paths are different how they get there. Not everyone's are the same. From what I hear, this girl had a very tragic background. But yes, my concern is absolutely for the child. I don't know if the child survived. I hope to God the child did survive. What she did was wrong. If she didn't want the child, she should have brought the child to the precinct. Okay, maybe that's a little unrealistic. Or to a church. Listen, there's safe haven laws. And I know it ain't just for New York. She should have brought that child, that poor baby, and gave that baby a fighting chance, regardless if it was addicted to drugs. God can do anything. That was a disgrace what she did. And she needs a lot of help. She needs to sit her ass behind bars and think about what she did to that child. Period. It's a disgrace. It's a living child. It's a baby, man. You know what I think of about my past? I say my past is done. Now it's my son's turn. I'm not gonna sit and wallow away. Oh, I was molested. Oh, my mother's living with this. Oh, my stepmother used to hurt me. No, I don't think, I tell my story as it was and as it is, as past tense, but I don't live in that. I live for the future. I look abroad. I say, look, I wanna do this, that, and the third. I wanna get my identification. I still couldn't get my ID. This is absolutely insane. There's a thing called New York One. And they will not help me because they're not issuing any new applications. I talked to the borough president. He called me back personally, or his assistant did, okay? And said to me, look, miss, we're not taking any new application, but we'll put you on the list. Listen, I need things done now. I wanna get my GED. I wanna go to school when my son goes to school. I wanna do something with my life. And I talked to my ex-husband, quotations, because it's not my ex-husband, it's still my husband. He won't help me. He's like, oh, what do you want me to do? Bitch, you got a fucking ID, because you're my son in here. You got an ID. Help me out, man. What? I said, I want to better my life. I want to go to school. I want to get my GED. I want to get a job. I want to be able to do things. I can't do nothing with no fucking identification. He won't do it, guys. Because he's afraid if I divorce him, he wants that control. He wants that control. I'll show you guys the text. I'll take a screenshot and show you guys. This is no bullshit. I asked him very cordially. I said, look, please. I said, George, because when my daughter came back in my life, you know, I'm not that kind of woman. I said, George, look, your daughter's home. She's with me. I asked G, I said, G, would you like to talk to your father? I didn't push her. I said, he's changing. And it seemed like he was. But look, you on Long Island, man. I called the town hall, the town of Brookhaven. I called them. I can't fax over what I have. They want me there in person. I can't get there. It's insane. Our truck ain't going there. Tito's not risking bringing the truck there. So what am I to do? It's like I got so much on my plate, guys. Barbarisa got a lot on her plate. But anyway, I just want to say, I pray, I don't know if that baby is alive, but I pray and hope that child survives being thrown in a trash can. Jessica, I hope God has mercy on your soul. Girl, I know you've been put through the ringer, me too, but I had a baby in the street and I had the baby in the hospital on Halloween, and the baby's still living today. He'll be 13 years old. There was no reason why you should have done that. And I'm sorry what you've been through, but that's a baby. And you can't say I don't know, because I do know. Because I had a baby in the streets. And I guarantee, if you would have seen the things I went through when I was pregnant in the street, you couldn't say a fucking word. So nobody better tell me, oh, you don't know what it's like. And I'm not saying this to none of you. None of you. I got mad because people try to use that shit. Oh, well, you don't know. You're not in their shoes. Oh, yes, I was. And I seen mad people that were in their shoes 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times in a row. I'm mad. Yes, I'm angry, guys. I'm frustrated. I want change in my life. I want to do something with my life. I'm stuck. I can't get an ID. I want to make some money. I want to get out of this situation. You guys don't understand what I'm going through, man. I can't express everything. But just know, Barbarisa, I want change. I want to do more. I want more for my child. This can't be it for him. And I don't mean this roof. I mean the situation. No, his mother needs to get her things together so I can better myself for his future. That's all I'm trying to do. And Chris Arnie is like, oh, get your ID and I'll help you. He knows I'm stuck. He knows New York one ain't issuing no. I showed him. Look, he did send me some links. Okay, fine. Oh, okay, someone's just sent me. You know what I'm saying? Okay, fine. You want to help me? I'm showing you that I'm stuck in a rock and a hard place, man. You got links. You got people that can help me. I'm doing the right thing. How long? You know what I'm saying? I'm always going to stay positive. But I could say this. There's some people, but how long? How long? You know how long? Forever, because of my son. And if it wasn't for that little boy, I don't know what I would do, man. I would have been probably gave up, maybe. Maybe. This is crazy, man. I'm so upset right now, guys. You have no idea, guys. This is, and then, you know, the truth is this. Like, if I can, and listen, I made a video last year, and this is the truth. I made a video about not caring about subs. And I was actually gonna ask everyone to unsubscribe because I didn't care about that, and I still don't. But you know what? Now I'm in a dire situation. Tito, we didn't know COVID was coming. Who knew COVID was going to happen? We running out of money. They said that Tito's unemployment is exhausted. Okay, so what am I to do? I only get $800 a month. Tito can't work. Let's be real, guys. He can't. They offered him a job next door. I was so excited. He's like, I can't do it. He can barely get up, guys. You see it. I feel bad for him. And I'm there for him. And I try the best I can. I do what I can for him. I'm supportive to him. And sometimes I don't get the same return, but I don't judge him. He's not thinking straight. He does love his son. He does buy stuff. He does take him to the park sometimes, like he's doing right now. Sometimes I gotta beg him to do it. But you know what? It is what it is, man. The man's doing the best he can. I'm not in his head. All I know is I support him and I love him and I take good care of my house and I take good care of my family. But the truth is that I need something to give, man. I need to make some extra money. I need to do something. If anybody out there can help me, not with money, but help me get up at least to 1,000 subs, guys. And I hate to ask this. I reached out to a couple of people, but I feel like they just, I don't know. I'm not gonna say who or what, but I don't wanna judge because maybe I'm jumping the gun too soon. Maybe they will, I don't know. But I'm just saying, if anybody can help me, anybody can help me get more subs up to 1,000. At least I can make a couple of extra dollars. I'm desperate right now, guys. I only get $800 a month. We pay all of our bills. All of our bills. And I will prove it to you guys. If I prove it to you guys, I pay all my bills. Will you guys help me get up to 1,000 subs? If I prove it to you and I show you my bills are paid. I gotta finish what I'm doing now, guys. I did a lot. I gotta hit that closet. Gotta hit the baby's closet now. I was supposed to do that early in the morning, but there was a lot of debris left over from last night. And me and the baby watched the movie WALL-E last night. We like, we gotta sit down and relax, babes. I sat down with the baby in the bed and he loved the movie WALL-E. Oh my God, I love that movie so much. Such a great movie. Oh guys, that was a load off. Let's pray for that Jessica's baby. Let's pray for Jessica too, because the Lord says we're supposed to pray. You know, not that she's my enemy, but you know, anybody who hurts a baby is an enemy of mine. I'm sorry. That's just how I am. I love children. Children, that's all I wanted to do was protect my kids and they were taken from me. So imagine how this makes me feel. I'm not judging you, girl. I'm praying for you. All right? God bless you all. Thank you, everyone, for your beautiful comments. Jesse Dunn, I had fun in your chat last night, girl. Ooh, Lord, there goes the prune juice. Ew. I gotta keep myself positive, guys. Like my little air conditioner. Look at this, guys. Isn't this cool? I gotta keep myself positive. Look. Look, isn't this nice? I did a good job. What? Yes. Ew. I don't know how. I do know how I do it, guys. I do it through the grace of the good Lord. The grace of the good Lord keeps me positive, guys. It's not me. It's not Barbarisi. Hi, everyone. Hello. You guys sleeping? Hello. Hello, 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 my babes. Oh, Lord, like my cacti. I got to show you guys my cacti. Hello, cacti. Want some water, babes? All right. Oh, God, you got to express it. You got to express the truth. The truth has to come out. I'm not a fraudulent person. I'm not a fake person. I say it like it is, and I tell it like it is. So, guys, yeah, Barbarisi's asking for a bit of help now, guys. I appreciate it, and I love you all. God bless you. Ciao.